Will Smurf from Black Community TV talking to Yolonda Ross, who is back for another season on The Chai and also has other projects coming up down the road. How's it going?
It's going great, man.
So what are we getting with The Chai in this upcoming season?
I mean, you're getting Black love, you know, all kinds of Black love. It's lighter than last season. And I know, I think it's kind of beautiful.
Mm-hmm. You know, take me back for those. I always think, you know, TV is weird, you know, in terms of like, you have your base and then you're going to get a new audience. The longer the show goes, the more of a new audience you're going to get. Especially now, you know, because there's marketing and so forth. So for a new audience who's going to catch up into, briefly describe, you said last season was a little bit dark and this is light this year, what your character went through last year.
I mean, my character was diagnosed with breast cancer last year. So she was battling that. And, you know, she made it out at the end of the season. And this year, you know, it's the aftermath of that and her dealing with love, you know, after dealing with cancer. So that's where we're at.
As an actress who has to go through the storyline, how did that help you out in terms of the research you did, you know, when you're playing this role? It's not that often we get characters going through cancer on a series.
Very true. I feel, especially Black women, you don't see it. I worked with a couple, like three organizations in Chicago, Equal Hope, Center for Health Equity Transformation, and the Tasha C. Joyner Foundation, which is in the South Side of Chicago. I met with women, heard their stories, got as much information as I could to bring to life this character who was battling cancer, because, you know, not everything could be written. So to put as much visually and physically into it that I could, I wanted to do that so that when they watched it, they'd see themselves for real, not like TV cancer, you know? Mm-hmm.
And that was the reason, the hair and all of that stuff. So it wasn't a wig, it was you cutting down your hair, right?
Yeah.
You know, she went full all into it, which is great. And then obviously, as you mentioned, you know, you experienced the love this year. And like that, you know, it's always good when the show comes back, you know, because you don't know what shows, specifically cable, you know, not all of them have a long run, but so far Showtime has invested in the show. The audience has invested with this show. What have you learned throughout the process with the different storylines that has helped you out as an actress?
I don't know about helping me as an actress. It's interesting to go through the different storylines just to keep me interested in things because, you know, you are playing the same person for years, you know, year after year after year. So for her to go into different situations is always exciting and energizing so that you can learn something new. That I will say about it, so that, you know, it just is helpful to have different things, your character going through different things. You can experience different things as that character.
Mm-hmm. And then with the ensemble, you know, how close-knit are you with this ensemble? Obviously, it's been, what, 5-7 years now? And like you said, it's the same character, but, you know, there's a core of you that's been on since day one.
Yeah, very true. I feel like me and my little family of, you know, Emmett, Jada, and Darnell, I feel like we are very close. And I feel like that translates onto screen. So, you know, there are others that, you know, I see, but it's this is the first season, maybe a little bit last year, where the characters kind of started, you know, entering other people's lives, because we were very separate before. Like, beginning, I really only saw Emmett. So I'm glad that we're, you know, getting into other people's worlds.
You also have Terror Lake Drive, which is the second season. You know, talk to me about that and finding the time to do that in between your regular day job.
Yeah, you know, I knew Jerry from New York, and I did Terror Lake like right before Christmas. It was a quick process. I think it was about like 3 weeks that we shot that. And you know, he explained it to me, and I was just sort of like, yeah, sure, let's do it. I'd never met Pascal, so she was great to work with, and I'd actually never worked with Jerry as well. It was just nice to be a part of his, you know, like, just like with The Shy, he got another chance, you know, another season.
What's the character all about in this second season?
My character is a nurse. She's a nurse, and I think she's going to school, but she's very vague. She's very vague on the show. So, yeah, I would say she's a nurse.
You like playing nurses, taking care of people.
Yeah, well, yeah. I don't know how much she's taking care of them in this show, but yeah.
You know, so, you know, what, finding work outside of The Shy, you got this one, you know, and now I wouldn't say everything's going back to normal, but how is looking for work these days in terms of, like, when you still have a day job and then trying to find time to do something else, whether it be a show or a movie?
I mean, it's not easy. I mean, people are funny about, you know, actors that are on shows, like, as if you can't do other things. Sometimes they write you off, like you're stuck in that thing and can't do other stuff. And then there are a lot of people that just know me and, you know, reach out, is she available? So one thing I'll say about it is when you're on a cable show, it only takes, it's less than half a year. So it's not a lot of time. It's a good chunk of time, but not a whole bunch of time. So you can do other things.
And when you're not working, you know, what keeps you humble, you know, just being normal, as opposed to somebody seeing you on the streets like, oh, I want you to come back.
I like being at home with my family, to be truthful. I like just going back to Nebraska.
Nebraska? Wow.
You know that's where I'm from. Yeah.
I did not know. After a while, you know, maybe I'm jaded enough to like, oh, she had an LA girl. Because every time I see you, you're in LA.
Yeah, well, no, you know what? That's true. That's true. Like right now, I'm around. I'm just around a lot.
And, you know, going back to The Shy, you know, when you're working with different directors, you know, what does each one of them bring to the table? You know, because you've been doing it for so long, but, you know, these shows have different directors that are coming in and out, and they have a tougher job in terms of keeping the continuity of the previous episodes. So they have to do a lot more work and a lot more research. And for you guys, you know, you're playing this character in and out for the last few seasons. Is it sometimes different when a new director comes in? And have you ever been in a position where goes, no, we don't, my character wouldn't do this or that? Or do they talk to you about, this is where we're going to go, like they did last year, giving your character cancer?
I mean, when directors come in, because it's like, directors aren't the writers, so that's a whole different thing. But I feel like for the most part, they're just very respectful that this is our house. You know what I mean? Like, we have created these characters from day one, and a lot of the crew has been there since day one. And those people, you know, they count on, you know, those directors count on all of us to do what we know to be correct for our characters and the show. And I feel like they color it with their own thing, but, you know, we're kind of like the driving force of it.
Mm-hmm. This upcoming season, I'm always trying to stop myself, because I'm like, is it season 5 or season 6?
5.
Season 5, I kept thinking 6. That's how long you've been around.
It didn't happen.
You know, but with season 5, you know, do you do like watch parties? Are you ready to see it?
You know what, we've been talking about that, trying to figure it out, because, you know, the thing is, people are all over the place. So trying to get people together, it's hard, you know, whether it's LA or New York, there's a lot of people in Atlanta as well.
Folks ain't coming to Nebraska.
Yeah, come on through. That would be hilarious.
You know, but hey, you know, you've got this show, it's been great. Obviously, you know, you're one of the benchmarks that people want to see where your character is going. It's good that they didn't kill you off, because they were like, nah, we don't need Black Twitter coming after Showtime. You know what I'm saying? Like, what'd y'all do? You know, so we don't need that. We need, you know, you keep Emmett on his toes, and at some point, he needs his mama to keep to stay sane, you know, because you never know when Emmett, you know, how many episodes take before Emmett reverses his old self.
Oh my gosh, please don't let that child revert.
You know, it's like, we don't know how long, how far he can go. But, you know, I think that storyline, that's the beauty about the show, is that their storylines are so different from the other. And then every now and then they'll have something where everybody's together, but it's like every 15 minutes within the show, you're going into another segment, another storyline with somebody else. It's different.
Mm-hmm. That's very true. I mean, I feel like our little family is pretty solid. There's a lot of craziness that goes on, but we kind of hold it down in our own positive way, which is nice, you know, because the show can be heavy.
Definitely not. You know, there have been some dark moments, but for the most part, you know, they know how to balance it out. And that's a credit to the writers, you know. So we are good to go. It's good talking to you. You too. Obviously, stay safe. You know, whenever I see you, it's always fun.
Yep, sure is.